Hey guys, what's going on? Hot off the heels of what I have to feel like was a very successful Easter Monday stream. It's time for the new return of Amp vs. SMW Central here on this channel, including, as I promised to a few people in chat, today's new Super Mario World ROM hack. You already kind of see it. I'm using ZMZ. Solid new intro screen. Iceman presents. Takes a second. Wait for it. In association with the FBI and Ghetto Youth. A couple of cool peeps. It's Toad's World! Made between 2006 and 2013 by Iceman. Obviously with some help and inspiration from FBI and Ghetto Youth. And this is brought to you by GameAnyone.com, as always. The plan for the Super Mario World ROM hacks is, at least the ones that are on my list, are to do them Mondays and Wednesdays with Torrent Tuesday tomorrow, Demo Day Thursday, as well as once a month Thursdays on top of the release of the stream archives from the previous weekend. Fan Game Friday, obviously, more SMBX. And then Random Weekend Saturday, which will be more Yoshi's Island, at least until I finish 2+. I think I'll take a break from that because a lot of people are getting really sick of it, I can tell. There's a lot of people in chat who are like, we're getting kind of sick of it. So we'll finish 2+ off in the next, if not this weekend coming, hopefully by the next one, we'll do something else after that. All right. This is actually a take two, as you can see, because I recorded a part one, and then it bunged up on me, and I had no commentary. I was like, ah, because I was messing with my audio settings Thursday, getting ready to stream. It didn't actually work out too good, so. But it's been a few days since I did this, so I don't remember much to it. Toad and his friends were playing in a forest full of colorful flowers. Totally amazed by the looks of it, they forgot that many people mysteriously disappeared in here without a trace. Nobody has ever seen them again. Can you find out why? How do you walk into a forest and not realize it's a forest where people have disappeared? I know, it's the plot of every good horror movie ever, or every bad horror movie ever. So, fair enough. Toad's house, basically just a... literally just a thing. There's nothing to it at all. Alright, Greenfields, number one. Solid toad start. You see, there's no HUD at all. It's cool. Notice, wild piranhas are living here in the green grass. Be careful. So yeah, no HUD at all. Oh yeah, I remember this. Here's the Yoshi's Island piranhas, and here's their hitbox. I'm just going to tool that just to show you. The hitbox is kind of weird, and the game kind of does this weird little laggy thing. Both at the end of the level and when you die, it's kind of weird. It kind of hesitates for a second before it actually kills you. Okay, forget that one. That's the last one. I'm trying to be a good little boy and cut back on the tool spam again, because I've been really letting that get away from me, so carry this with me, except I'm not, because I just killed myself. Alright. From what I played of this the first time, I remember this is actually pretty good. The levels are long, but they're not overly difficult, so as long as keep a level ahead, we should be alright here. But yeah, oh boy, there's the midpoint flag, which for some reason respawns. Wasn't placed correctly, so it always respawns. Or I shouldn't say respawns, but if you leave this section and come back, like if you go in a pipe and come back out of pipe after you got the midpoint, it comes back again. It's weird. Alright. Fire Toad, I guess he's slightly different color. What? How do I... oh, I have to go back up here, that's how. But yeah, special thanks to everybody who came out both on Friday and today for my first official live shows. I appreciate it. Everybody seemed like they had a good time. Didn't have any troll issues or anything. That was great. And we'll definitely tentatively do it again next weekend, Sunday and Monday, if I'm not working. I'll know in the next probably 24 to 48 hours what my schedule for the next week is. Actually, I'll know for the next 2 weeks. But I can tell you right now, I'm not working April 10th through 16th. Yes, I shouldn't be. I requested that time off for a week off, so there will be lots of streaming that week, if not exclusively. So stay tuned for updates on that. But definitely, we'll definitely be keeping our eye out. And hopefully by the time I get to midweek, I'll know what's going on. I'll be able to tweet it out. So follow me on Twitter if you don't already. All right. Greenfields 2. What's going on here? So I don't necessarily plan to get exactly as far as I did the first time. Because I know I don't have to explore. I don't have to be as thorough with exploration as I was the first time. So it's a thing. If I can get a little further, I will. Ooh, hello, guy. Thankfully, you can spin jump on those plants. It's definitely interesting, to say the least. This music's a little creepy, but I don't know if that's inaccurate music or if that's actually the way it's supposed to be. I wouldn't be surprised if this is the way it's supposed to be. Hey there, Goomba. I should have waited to see if he'd done the little eye wink thing before he jumped. Before he walked off. Do I have to go down there or up here? Or does it matter? I guess it was up here. Definitely a very, very... Like, you've got Super Paper Mario blocks. You've got a Toad who clearly looks like he's from some form of the new Super Mario Brothers series, some way or another, or possibly a 3D Mario. Some of the redrawn sprite sets here. Got the Yoshi's Island plants, we got the Yoshi's Island Goombas, got the redrawn Koopas and Piranhas. Just a hybrid of a whole bunch of things here. I don't think I need to go that way. I think I just need to keep moving this way. There we go. Boom. Very, very interesting, I must say. I think that bam, wham is pretty much one of the only remaining Super Mario World vanilla elements outside of maybe the border here, but even that's a different color, so. And this definitely is a total graphical and level overhaul. Oh, there's the Yoshi's Island Shy Guys. Rocking it out into his house. Okay. A little bit careful here. Some precision jumping at play. Midpoint flag's right there, but I'm going to go down here and see what... Oh, I remember this. Okay, I gotta be careful because these actually do have... These actually are contoured the way they look, so they do slope down at their ends, and I remember in the first take, I walked right off the edge because I didn't think I... Because the corner was a little sooner than I thought it was. Grab that. Whoops. All right. I've got the Mario 3 power down, where I go back to being Super Toad first before I go small, so that's a little bit forgiving in that sense, at least. Level has a ceiling on it. See, we got these Yoshi's Island platforms going here. Whew, okay. Got lucky on that one. Yeah, I feel like I can do good in this and not die too much, because I just spent like 2.5 hours playing Janked Up Mario Party Tool Free, and I actually did really, really well. I was actually surprised. Made it all the way into the third world without any substantial rage issues. So far, so good. We'll see what happens next weekend. I'll definitely schedule that game for a block next weekend. Finish off 3X and do 3 Mix some more. for sure. Got to finish those off, and then I don't plan on doing more of Central Production. I just wanted to do that kind of as a warm up. Power up over here, isn't there? Maybe. Nope. Another thing you'll know is a lot of multi-coin blocks around here. You think you go looking for into a nook and you think it's going to be a power-up? Nah. Won't be a power-up. It'll just be a multi-coin block because why not? Like, for example, there's nothing over there, but... Okay, so if you run away before the death animation finishes, he will respawn. All right. Good information. Solid to know. I think I actually asked myself that at one point in the first take. Was, if I were to kill this guy and leave, would he still respawn? And he apparently did. Now, I'm sure if I waited for him to actually die, he wouldn't come back, but... But yeah, hey there. I love how the shy guys just explode into a puff of dust. Yeah, they do the full animation. They do the full animation. No, I remember what I asked myself. I asked myself if I were to... I remember now. I asked myself, I said, if I killed it and then touched it while it was dying, would it still hurt me? And it didn't, so... Apparently, no. I think they just respawn no matter what. I think... Was that the one I killed earlier? That came back there a moment ago? Oh! Didn't save it. Thought there'd be a safety platform. There was not. That's alright. That's right at the midpoint. No big deal. No big deal at all. We're good. Yeah, I'm right here. See, the midpoint just comes back. So you can make yourself big again immediately. Yeah, see, I'd not go down that ladder again. I just confirm my point here. See, kill it. Leave, come back. No, all right. Maybe that wasn't the plant I killed then. Clearly that was not the plant you were looking for. This was the power of the pipe I was looking for. One random munchy plant is kind of hanging out on the ceiling there, like in the least likeliest place to ever hurt you, no less. It makes for nice decoration, you see. I see what's going on there. Incinerator to Goomba. I feel very, very much... feel very much proud of myself. Oh, I didn't even need this. Awesome. I don't know what's up with the little... bit of lag there when you grab the goal, but... Yeah, fair play. Apparently there's no time limit, and there's apparently no score, even though you do get a point count. Right, castle number one. Oh yeah, I remember I noted this. Toad's slightly shocked face when you look up. Oh. Oh. Actually, no. Toad doesn't go, "Oh," he goes, "Ha!" Or something goofy like that, because he has a breathing, annoying voice that just makes you want to punch him in the face. Makes sense whenever you hear, "Sorry, but your princess is in another castle." You're just like, "Yeah. Yeah, Toad, she is. Why do you have to rub this in? Clearly you're not her, and therefore she is not here, so..." Alright, now, press down on these ropes to go through, but no information to tell you that. It just happens. Was it up here I needed to be? No. You also have no reserve power-up. Press select, nothing happens, so... I guess that's why you power down Mario 3 style, because you don't have that... that thing. So you don't have the safety net of a reserve power-up, so it just lets you power down gradually. Alright, just gotta dap. That didn't actually lead me to anything other than another power-up I can't use. Alright, I think midpoint here? I think? Or no. I think this is where I need to be, if I recall correctly. Or it doesn't matter and you just... the two paths brand... yeah, the two paths just come back together. At that climbing net, I think. Not sure. Something going on up there, but... Okay, so there's no midpoint. You gotta be careful here. And you get a little bit of Mega Man door physics. Because why the hell not? Along with a... I must admit, a very good port of the boss fight music from Yoshi's Island. You gotta be careful not to get scythe in the face. And then, not get fireballed in the face. Right? Isn't hard either. Gotta do a little bit of... Right, and then, just keep... There! Toad has set the ghost an end, which makes no grammatical sense, but that was just the beginning of an exciting adventure. We are now going to the Wilderness Road where all wild creatures live. By the way, shout out to the Kirby Victory music. Underrated victory theme. Too bad Toad didn't split into three and start dancing, because then somebody would be set to do a thing. Can we go... time ever. There we go. Alright. Warp pipe into the mystery tube. I believe this game just auto-saves or something, because I haven't seen a save prompt yet, and it did save my progress, so I don't know. Wilderness Road 1. Okay, now... See, what's happened here is, I don't believe DMZ can handle the power anymore. 9X just can't handle it. So I'll have to switch emulators. I'll be right back. Okay. Having switched over, and it did save my progress. Good. The SRAM's the same. All right. So we should be okay now. Try this again. Wilderness Road 1. There we go. Now we're in business. Notice, finding the secret palace may help on your journey. Cool. Now granted, this may result in some slightly glitchier sound effects because ZSNES not being a very accurate emulator. This is a fairly recent release, so maybe we might be okay. Because if it works on an accurate emulator, it should work on this. Maybe it sounds like the jump sound effect's a little higher pitched than usual, but... nothing direly broken about it. It starts going whoop. Then we know we're in trouble. But we'll just have to put up with it. Oh yes. Okay. Sentient fireball, please. Of course, as usual, the fire plants have now begun spitting two fireballs, as they always do in the second world of anything. FPI Productions clearly was here because they've made me build a bridge. Shout out to the second Reality Project, 1 and 2, with the third one in the works. From what I understand, whoops. That's okay, I didn't need that mushroom power-up anyway. I am myself a mushroom and therefore capable of handling things myself. Must admit, this Yoshi's Island port is actually not too bad. It's a little off in spots, tone-wise, but actually pretty accurate to the actual Yoshi's Island game. And don't worry, this is the closest to a Yoshi's Island game you're going to see till Saturday. Don't worry about it. I know that those of you who like it, shout out to you, and I as do I. But I mean, come on. All right. Cool stuff. I might do the rest of them maybe on Game Anyone or something. To avoid the anger and hatred. Of course, that would require skipping 2 plus 2, but that's fine. I already done it. Alright, Wilderness Road 2. Red level. And we see our old friend the Stompy Stomp Koopa. Love to... There we go. Would absolutely love... not put up a Stompy Stomp Koopa, but that's just not in the cards, you see. does not do much of a duck, I must admit. His duck is more of a squat, and I don't want to know what he's trying to do while he's doing that. Yeah, it did not need fireballs or anything. Really? All right. Need that either. Can I please kill the Stompy Turtle? Thank you. What do you wager? That's the next boss, too. Doggone it, FPI Productions. You and your bridge-building tactics. Spreading to other games now. Okay, whoop. No, please. Please don't earthquake me into submission. I don't like that. Thankfully, it's just a one-hit kill. Alright, now we're back to a healthy size, and now we have ammunition with which to defend ourselves from the oncoming plague of evil. No jumping, Charlie. That's enough. Okay, so long story, incredibly short. This level is about turtles and other life forms wearing things. Clearly, that is the point. See, by my rampant murdering of all form of reptilian life, Toad cares not for any form of reptilian life. Pretty great. It is pretty, pretty great.
Now, what about the secret exit, you're wondering? Well, I'm glad you asked, person whom I probably don't know on a personal level. If I get killed by a turtle that kind of glitches into the ground, alright, sure. What you may or may not know, and this is probably in chipmunk time, by the way, for those of you who don't know, is again, nobody wants to watch you. You don't watch this in one fell swoop. Without tool spam, you gotta speed things up. It's the Raukow How to Be a Good Rumpack Player Guide in 10 Easy Steps manual thing. Thank you, Earthquake, for ruining my day, taking my fire away. That was pretty great. He's an eternally awesome guy. That's why you probably should be killing those turtles you encounter instead of ignoring them, because they will do stuff. The stuff they do is not normally known for to be that, you know, that good for you. Just throw that out there. That being said, people ask me where the midpoint was, and I'm telling you right now, I know where it is. It's actually fairly obvious. You probably already guessed where it was, because you're all smart people. You see? Never
turn speech. Somewhere in the vicinity of here. That looks like a very suspicious 3 coins. There's no way you could get those without falling in the hole, right? Oops. Oh, well, what do you know? Couldn't have made that more obvious if you tried to. I mean, you could have made it an actual arrow, and then it would have been pretty much a dead giveaway, but hey, why not? We'll just go with it. But that doesn't lead to a Switch Palace. It leads to a wilderness secret, which is basically just a top secret area where you can top your power up and collect a few coins for your own personal amusement more than anything else. Alright, we need to go over here. Wild Mountain 1. I think it was the last level I did in the first take, but okay. My first complaint is the music. This port is a little bit off. You can hear it. This is like that. This is like your high school band with that one player. You have one person playing off key, but they won't admit it. No one will admit it's them. Yeah, follow those coins down. I also made the mistake of trying to juke and jive because I thought there'd be 2 coins on the other side again. Nah, that doesn't happen. You fall in the hole and you're dead. So it's be amazing. All right. Excuse me. But outside of the slightly disturbing musical number chosen, it's actually a pretty good level. Well designed, well made. Pretty well across the board. And, yeah. I don't have much more to say. It's basically this. Hard to come up with things to say when you've already played it once. That's the problem. So that's why we'll do one non-blind. We'll do one blind one, which will be the Ghost House coming up. Because I actually have no idea what's coming up in that one. So I don't need that. I got fire already. I'll leave it there. May it sprout and grow spawn new ones everywhere, ever. Whoa. Bullet Bill, please. Passing through. Okay. So we'll do one more. I think this ghost has coming up as a red level, because I saw two paths for leaving it. That will give me something, some new content, something to actually comment on. Spooky Road. Somebody somewhere saying a meme. Good for you. Ooh, some actual terrifying music here. Oh, just continuing to summon fire. Summoning fire out of fear for himself and others. Be fantastic. Oh, hello, Big Boo. How you doing? So, he looks half embarrassed and half annoyed when you face him. Boo Ring, just taunting. Even more so news. Oh, look, there's a door down there. I wonder if that's suspicious in any way, shape, form, or fashion. We'll have to find out later, won't we? Okay, hi there, Big Boo. Midpoint. Boy, I wonder if that door down there was at all suspicious. Whatsoever. Couldn't possibly be. We'll have to find out later. All right. No, I guess you do have to go in that door. All right. Statement retracted. It's not a suspicious door. It's a required door. You just have to do this in the right order. Okay. No. Keep my eyes open for anything suspicious Aloysius here. Take a big leap over that. I like how Toad just looks like perpetually surprised, even when he's just standing still. Hard to see, I know, but he does have a very slight. Even when he's ducking, he looks concerned about everything. The creepiest thing ever. I'm in a level full of ghosts, so I know there's some creepy stuff going on here. Alright. There's the goal. Ah, but the level keeps going, I see. Alright. I understand where you're coming from. But we'll visit that in just a moment. Because I get it, I understand. That goes to here. Wild Mountain 2, that's great.
We'll look at that on Wednesday, but we'll also look at whatever the secret exit's going to give us. So you always want to check past the goal on level 2 exits if you haven't seen anything suspicious. If you can get past the goal, do it. Because it's probably got something. That's like how he's embarrassed, but he's annoyed, he's embarrassed at the same time. He's like, come on, look away. It's like, I'm not actually embarrassed, I'm not actually afraid to look at you, I'm just. I just don't want to put up with shenanigans. Right? I just probably. You know what, that was a bad move. Okay, let's just. We're at the midpoint here, just as a safety feature. If I mess this second half up at all, which, oh, in my luck, I probably would. Let's get the Firefly back, which is a good thing in most cases. Okie dokie. I gotta make it back to the first goal. Big Boo, please. Look at me, I'm totally terrified. Are you kidding me? Let me adjust my mic. I'm gonna set my headphones on the top of my head again. It's hilarious. Now sometimes they just slide down your head when you're trying to stare at the computer screen. There we go. That'll stay there for like 30 seconds. That's a move again. Go figure. Alright. What do you got for me? Whoop, whoop, whoop. Alright.
I just notice when Toad slides, his facial expression, again, is hysterical as well. Alright, so if I go past here, I get a 1-up and the second goal. Alright. What does that open, per se? Do we know when it opens? Well, somebody knows, but I don't. It opens path over here. Secret Palace! Actually, you know what? We'll do this too, and then we'll wrap it here. Okay. Shout out to Mario. Okay, it gives me a cape. Which may or may not be helpful in my quest. I haven't gotten a cape yet, so that is actually maybe a useful thing. We'll find out how useful it is on Wednesday. When we resume from here, don't forget tomorrow is the next episode of Torrent Tuesday, where I believe we're playing a couple more ROM hacks. In fact, I'll even take the time to bring up the list so you can see it for yourself. prove that I'm not a phony liar. Where is the folder? It's right here. See, I already deleted the first one to make sure that I knew what I'd already played because it wasn't that good. So Basic Land, which is a demo, and if that doesn't take me an hour, Beginning of Mythario is also a demo. I suspect both of these combined will be plenty long enough. We'll see how those look next time. That's tomorrow on Torrent Tuesday. Like I said, more of this here on Wednesday. Thanks for watching. We will, as always, see you then.